Hello viewers, today we are going to see about the Mars. I have already done the video related to the Mars, being a Mars is a desire. So now what balance? But no, the great things about the Mars, I have not disclosed it. And that Mars is very important for somebody's life, like a marriage life. For marriage, Mars is a very important planet. It is also called Mangal Dosha or Kuja Dosha. In the south, it is called Kuja Dosha also. Kuja is a Mangal, right? So it's a Mangal Dosha. Now, first of all, we have to learn what is a Mars actually. As we have seen, Mars is a desire, that's a burning desire that we all seen. But actually, what is a Mars? In the place of Mars, see, people say Mars is anger, Mars is anxiety, Mars is all type of fighting. No, Mars is not like this. In our blood, we know the blood have three parts. WBC, that's a white cell, that is sun. In blood, there is a RBC, red blood counting. Yeah, it is Mangal, that is Mars, and we have plasma, that is moon. So there are three factors affecting this, and basically this Mars is affecting our RBC, that is called red blood counting. Now this red blood counting is also affecting a hemoglobin, and hemoglobin contains with the iron. Again, iron is a Mars. See, that metal, iron. Right, so Mars is nothing but the iron energy in our body. Our red blood cell, very important, right? So what is Mars? So Mars is a strength. It is called Shakti, strength. It is called Urja, that is energy. And it is called Utsah. Utsah means enthusiasm, right? So it is nothing but the strength, energy and enthusiasm. Now you, in place of a Mars, if you put these three words, you will realize, yeah, this is really a Mars. Like in third house is a house of courage. So to do a new things, do a courage, you need some strength, energy and enthusiasm. Mars is also a significator of a property. When you are going to purchase a property, what you need? You need a strength. You need energy, means money, and you need enthusiasm. You must have enthusiasm. No, I want to purchase a property. So that is a Mars. For sixth house, the Mars is a significator of a disease, rogue, ring, all type of death, enemies, shatru, and your maternal home, your mother's brother. So all these things, if you want to get rid of your disease, what you need? You need strength, energy and enthusiasm. To fight with the enemy, what you need? That is Shakti, Urja and Utsa, strength, energy and enthusiasm. So this is all very important, that the Mars is nothing but the energy. It's strength. It's RBC. See, now why Shastra and all Rishi Muni has said Mangal is not good. Good, it's a Kuja Dosha, it's a Mangal Dosha, because they know those who have a Mars, they are very powerful. They have so much capacity to work. They have so much energy to work. But what about the other person who doesn't have a Mars? They can't cope up with this, and that is why they have kept them different from others. Right? So for keeping a different thing, they have made that you have a Mangal Dosha. See what happened, if you have a Mangal Dosha, that means you are very powerful, your energy is something very fast, you have a strength, you have energy and you have enthusiasm. But if your strength, your energy doesn't cope up with your partner, then there will be a clash. What happened if that two energy clash each other, one energy having too much power, too much intensity, and another energy is a passive. We can't compare about the active and passive energy. So those who have a Mangal, Mars, they are very enthusiasm. See, you see, who have a Mangal Dosha? Basically, you will find all doctors, because they are working with the Mars. They are very strengthful. They are very energetic and very enthusiasm. Also positive attitude also there. And that is why if Mars is very powerful in your chart, if it is in ohms and exalted, then you have a positive attitude. That is why it is called, it is a life force. It is a positive attitude also in one's life. So Mars gives so much enthusiasm, and daily when you have a active life, your Mars should be very perfect. And Mars color, you see the color of a Mars is also red. That is why I also wear the red color. So to give a tribute to the Mars. Why people think only about to go to Mars? Because that is a similarity having Earth. It has have a same energy as the Earth have. That is why people only think about to move to the Mars. And many people have purchased the land also in the Mars. It's a karaka of a land also, right? So all doctors, all engineers, all the researcher, all technical person have Mars very powerful. See, in when I was a student, we have one professor called Navin Javeri sir. Oh, great personality. He has written one book, Shani Mangal Yuti Pratiyuti. In 1981, he wrote that book. I have only one copy, and that was a fantastic. What he says that there's always a chasing between Mars and Saturn. Mars being the police, and Saturn we think about the theft. So there's always fight between and chasing between Mars and Saturn. He said that Shani Mangal always create a Sangharsh Yoga. Sangharsh Yoga means you can say the challenge taking. Or you can say that the fighting nature. Because Mars is so powerful, he doesn't stop. And Saturn is so slow, it doesn't stand up. So there's a chasing between this. He always said that those who have a Shani Mangal, Saturn and Mars together, they will be industrialists. If Saturn and Mars have a Kendra Yoga, if Mars to Saturn is in the fourth house, so Mars will aspect Saturn, Saturn will aspect Mars. If Mars and Saturn is a pratiyuti, both are each other, both is opposite to each other, again they will aspect each other, control each other. But in the situation where the Mars is, Mars to Saturn is a 10th, Mars is sitting where first house and Saturn in the 10th house or anywhere in the 4th, 10th, then what happens, Mars will not affect Saturn and Saturn will also not affect the Mars. But in the rest condition, wherever the Saturn and Mars is together, yuti, Saturn, Mars, Kendra, 4th and 10th, or Pratiyuti, each other opposition, then there is called a Sangharsh Yoga. You will find the people, their biography you will read, they will start up with the nothing and they will reach to something. That is a chasing of a Saturn and Mars. So that is why Shastrakar said that they don't afraid of Mars. But what happened if they don't create that Mars being a dosha, then people will match anybody. See, many people say only the Indians believe it is a Mangal Dosha, and this Mangal Dosha they only see. But you see that the divorce rate and separation rate is main and major in the US and other countries, not in India, because at least we have settled that energy. What happened that after marriage there is a consummation. Everybody will agree. So during the consummation, if one energy is fast and another energy is slow or passive, there will be a destruction. And that is why also a Mars has to be matched with the other's Mars, so that there won't be destruction between them. And there is also a blood transformation. The genes or the sperm transit to the travels to the female. So that is why also Mars is very important to see. Now people say that whoever have a Mars, they have a dosha. No, I said those who have a Mars, they have energy. Rest of people, they have to gather the energy. Whereas those people having a Mangal dosha or having a Mars in certain houses, they have inbuilt energy. See, one is like to run anything. Suppose like a mobile, if you want to run the mobile, you have to charge or you have to keep a battery. Suppose a torch if you're using, you have to put a battery. But for tube light, it's automatic energy. That's electricity power will be there. So somebody have an inbuilt energy and somebody's energy has to be created. So those who having a Mars, now you should be very powerful. You should not afraid telling that I have a Mangal dosha. I also believe that those who have a Mangal, Mars dosha, or Mars in the certain house, they are more powerful than those who doesn't have a Mars, because their cells is always giving a fast response. And who has also, World Health Organization also has given that those whose RBC is a very powerful and fast, they can fight the cancer cell very much. I can add this, that I have seen so many cancer patients in research in my medical research. When I have done PhD, three times I have done PhD. During my PhD, I have studied so many cases of cancer. I have done, I have launched also one campaign for cancer also. I'll advise the people, those who are suffering from cancer, if you are aware about it, just send me the kundli. I'll give them a remedy, whether they will be survive or not. So during cancer also, I have seen somebody have an inbuilt energy and they have fight against the cancer. Those who have Mangal Dosha in Mangal in certain place. Now, where this Mangal Dosha has to be placed? See, it has been given that in the first house, fourth house, seventh house, eighth house and twelfth house. Where if Mars is placed, then it will also affect your partner life also, because first house is your own body. It will be accelerate your activities is more faster than others. In fourth house, you are more seeking of you have a more desire of a pleasure, and you seek that other person also should have a same thing, and you want to enjoy together. Seventh house is for the partner. Eighth house is for lifespan also and for the sexual organ also. So that also somebody have a fast sexuality and somebody have a passiveness. So that is also eighth house for life also and for personal energy also. And for 12th house, see why the Mangal has given a dosh in the 12th house, because it is not only a bad pleasure. Yeah, I believe this is a bad pleasure. Bad means shayan, ashan, shayan and bhog, it is called in the Sanskrit, ashan, shayan and bhog. So it is a bad pleasure, as well as this is a house of bandhan, not whether you will be living loyalty with your partner or not, that can be seen from 12th house. Because 12th house Karak is a Saturn, but if Mars is seated or Mars is affected, that means you are not much keen about all rules and regulation, and you may break rules and regulation anytime. So that is a Mars. But I also consider Mars or Mangal Dosha in the second house also, because your life is life in your eighth house. But your, what about your partner life? Your partner life is your second house. Your partner family is second house. One has to believe. So your partner life is also very considerable. See, in India, all female, all married women, especially where there's a Mangal Sutra. You might have seen that golden, that's Mangal Sutra, where the black beads will be that. Black beads. What that black beads indicates, that black beads is nothing but the placing a Saturn in the second house of a wife, which enhance the life of his husband. Because for female, second house is a house of husband life. And while wearing a Mangal Sutra, they are increasing the lifespan of her husband. Because previously, the female was always depend on the husband. So they have to wear this, and husband life is very important in their life. If their life has to survive, the husband should be there. That is why previously and traditionally women are wearing a entire black color beads, this Mangal Sutra. Nowadays you will find more gold, and then say many women also complaining, my husband has so much ego. Yeah, because you have wear more gold rather than the black beads. So gold, sun, ego. So you might have created that distraction. Be careful. So that is why the women are wearing. So I also consider the second house, if a Mars is placed, that is also a Kuja dosha. In Shastra also it is mentioned that if a Mars is in the second house, one has to consider as a Mangal dosha or Mars in the destruction. Now Rishi Muni says that this Mangal dosha has to be seen from ascendant, from moon, as well as from Venus. You have to make a moon chart, you have to place moon in the first house and make a kundli, that is called Chandra kundli. You can also make a Venus kundli by placing a Venus in the first house and rest all the planet accordingly. And you have to see if your Mars is placed first, second, fourth house, seventh house, eighth house and 12th house, then it will be a Mangal Dosha. Means your Mangal is harming your marriage life and compatibility with your partner. So you need a partner having a equal energy. See, it doesn't mean that if your Mars is in the 4th house, your spouse how Mars also should be in the 4th house. No, it's not mentioned like this. Any of this house, it can be any of this house where the Mars has to be seated. So why they have said it has to be seen from Ascendant, Moon and Venus? Ascendant means it is all your physical action. Moon means from Moon, if you are seeing your Kujados or Mangaldos is now there or not, that is all your mental stress, mental activities and mental tendency. And why it has to be seen from Venus? Because Venus is a planet of pleasure. Whether you are seeking more pleasure, you are very aggressive during enjoying any pleasure, so that is also it be seen from Venus. But I advise you not to see from Moon, because it indicates your internal desire, internal Moon inside your mind. But it doesn't affect. See, suppose physically you are very hyper, but mentally if you are very aggressive, it doesn't affect the other person, but physically it does affect. And Venus is only during the time of pleasure, bad pleasure or sexuality. Okay, I have seen many cases where the Venus in Venus chart, if your Venus chart, if Mars is placed in the triangle, then people are more active in their sexuality. See, when I say something in general, don't catch my word. I have seen so many viewers writing, I don't have this. I have given my observation. One has to be seen that whether it work or not, or whether in if it is exalted, is debilitated, is own sign, it is enemy sign, is friendly sign, it differ, and dasha also differ. So whenever the Mars is placed in the triangle in the Venus kundli, they have a very much tendency and hyperness during the pleasure or sexuality. So it is always found. Now, so it is decided that it has to be only seen from the ascendant, means Lagna Kundli, only ascendant chart you have to see Mars. If it is placed in first house, second house, fourth house, seventh house, eighth house or 12th house, then it will be saying that it will be affecting your marriage life. Now, after this, one has to see that whether even the sitting of a Mars in the 1st, 2nd, 4th, 7th, 8th and 12th house, it may affect, may not be affecting. So, one has to see why it doesn't affect. So, Shastrakar has given so many ways by which even though Mars has placed in that house, but still there won't be a Mangal Dosha. See, Mars in that house, it means you have Mangal. But if Mars has comes under the exceptions, then there was no Mangal Dosha. You don't restrict them. See, Mangal has its luck house to 28. That is why those who have a Mangal Dosha, people always advise them, do marriage after 28, Mangal will not affect. No, once your nature has become under the tendency of Mars, you will be always in the hurry. You will be always in this, too much energy, strength and enthusiasm will be always there. Yeah, but it is there after 28, it won't be much powerful. See, Mars age is, Bhagyodaya verse is given 28. On the half of it, it's a 14. And all the people will agree that 14 is the age of puberty, where your cells will change, your RBC will change. Female gets their menstruals. Their cycle start on the 14th and it's a time of puberty. Again, that is RBC and Mars, right? So that is the age of puberty, and on 28 is on its peak. On 14 onward, it has started out the half, and on 28, it's on the peak, right? So that is about the Mars. Now we'll see even though, what are the exceptions given in the Mars? See, all these exception has been already given in Jatak, Parijatak and everything. I also see many things in the many thing texts, but there are, I have stated 21 different exception to the Mangal Dosha. If people apply this exception, then they will able to know that Mangal Dosha doesn't affect in all chart. And one should be always give a right direction. Now we'll see which condition where the even though Mars has sitting in the Mangal Dosha house, it will not affect anyone in the Mangal Dosha. The first of all, if it is a Swagrahi Mangal, if a Mars is in own sign. So if it is in the Aries or a Scorpio sign, Mars has placed his own house. Why he should destruct his own house? So first exception to the Mangal Dosha is own sign. If Mars has seated in its own sign, then it won't affect you as like a Mangal Dosha. Second, if Mars is exalted, right? If Mars is exalted, then it won't affect you because everybody is seeing your energy and that energy always being used in the positive and creative ways. If Mars is debilitated, that also Mars have a very little say. Debilitated planet means it has been suppressed. If it is suppressed, it doesn't have any say. So thereby also you will save. So that also give a good result that if Mars is own sign, exalted, if it is debilitated, if it is combust, if Sun is seated with the Mars and Sun has taken all the power of the Mars, then if it is combust. Mars and this Sun combust on 17 degree, if they are together plus minus 17 degree, if Sun from Mars is 17 degree plus or minus ahead or back, then it will be a combust. Then combustion Mars also doesn't give a Mangal Dosha. So own sign, exalted, debilitated, combust, and if Mars is seated with good planets like Jupiter and Venus, or seated in the Jupiter and Venus sign, if your Jupiter Mars is placed in the Sagittarius or Pisces, Dhanu Rashi or Meen Rashi, if the Mars is there is no Mangal Dosha because it is seated with the good container. Rashi is nothing but the container. And if it is placed in the Venus sign like Taurus and Libra, Vrishabh and Tula Rashi, then also there is no Mangal Dosha. So this is the five basic principle we will see one by one. If your Mars is in the 7th house in the mean, if it is placed in the Pisces in the 7th house, no Mangal Dosha. If it is in 8th and in the Kumbh Rashi, if it is in the Aquarius sign and in it is 8th house, no Mangal Dosha. If Mars is in the 12th house and in the Sagittarius, that I already mentioned in the 12th house. If Mars is seated with the Jupiter, if Mars is seated with the Venus, no Mangal Dosha. Then if Chandra and Mangal, Moon and Mars are seated together, Anshatmak, degreekali. Degreekali means within the 5 degree. If they both are seated 5 degrees, no Mangal Dosha. Okay. If Mangal, if Mars is aspected by good planet either Jupiter or Venus, no Mangal Dosha. If Mars dispositor, Mars is sitting in whose sign, that planet is placed Kendra to Moon, no Mangal Dosha. So rule says if a dispositor of Mars is seated Kendra to a Moon, there is no Mangal Dosha, right? Then you have if Mars is in the own triangle, means a Mula Trikona Rasi, then also there is no Mangal Dosha. If Kanya, if Mars is in the Virgo sign, 2nd house or 12th house, no Mangal Dosha. If it is in the Venus house, in the 4th or 12th, no Mangal Dosha. If 1st, 2nd, 4th, 7th, 12th house, if Venus is aspecting that house, there is no Mangal Dosha. If Saturn is placed 6 or 8 from Mars, if Mars is seated suppose in the 10th house, and if your Saturn is placed in the 3rd house or 5th house, no Mangal Dosha. Mangal, wherever Mars is placed, from Mars if Saturn is in 6th or 8th house, no Mangal Dosha. If in your chart Venus is very powerful, Venus is exalted, Venus in own sign, even though Mars is placed in the this Mangal Dosha house, no Mangal Dosha. And last 12, if husband or wife have a Angarak Dosha. See, Angarak Dosha is different from the Mangal Dosha. Angarak Dosha means placement of a Sun and Mars. If Sun and Mars too far seated together, then it will be blast, no Mangal Dosha. If either partner have a Mangal Dosha and other partner have this Angarak Dosha, there is no Mangal Dosha. That will nullify. Now, there's all 21 rules I have said, that whereby even though Mars has seated in 1st, 2nd, 4th, 7th, 8th and 12th house, there will be no Mangal Dosha. So now if we consider this all planetary position, all these rules, then one can write down and draw the chart as I have drawn. See, I have drawn this chart whereby I can see to it that where the Mangal gives Mangal Dosha is there or not. Now what it says, if Aries ascendant, there is no Mangal Dosha. Because in first house is own sign, second house is the Venus house, fourth house is debilitated, seventh house is the Venus house, eighth house own sign, and 12th house is in the Jupiter sign. No Mangal Dosha. Likewise in the Taurus, if Mars is placed in second house and fourth house, only Mangal Dosha will there. Okay, in Gemini ascendant, if Mars is placed in first house, second house and fourth house, then only there will be a Mangal Dosha. If in the Cancer and Cancer ascendant, if a Mars is seated in the first house, second house and 12th house, then only Mangal Dosha will be there. I'll be publishing this table after this video and posting in the video itself and as well as in the Facebook also, so viewers can view. If a Leo ascendant, then your Mars is placed in 1st house, 7th house and 12th house, then only you have a Mangal Dosha. In the Virgo ascendant, if Mars is placed in the 1st house and in the 12th house, then only there will be a Mangal Dosha. In Libra ascendant, entire Libra ascendant, no Mangal Dosha. In Scorpio ascendant, if Mars is placed in your 4th house or 8th house, then only a Mangal Dosha will be there. In Sagittarius ascendant, if your Mars is placed in the 7th house, right, or in the 8th house, then only a Mangal Dosha will be there. In Capricorn ascendant, if Mars is placed in 2nd house and 8th house, then only you have a Mangal Dosha. In your Aquarius ascendant, if a Mars is placed in 1st, 7th and 8th house, then only there will be a Mangal Dosha. And in Pisces ascendant, if your Mars is placed in 4th house, 7th house and 12th house, then only it will be a Mangal Dosha. See, this is only a placement. But after in this house also, if it is Surya Mangal Angarak Yoga, if it is placed with the Venus, again you will get an exception. So this is a common things I have made for the viewers. One can stop the screen and can see and view this. So I always use such a type of a shortcut to remember. So this is all about Mars. Now one more misconception about the Mangal Dosha is that if one has a Mangal Dosha, you can match it with another Saturn. How it can be possible? See, in the original text it has not mentioned. It might be added later on. See, previously what happened, if one has a Mangal and another has a Saturn, they say that they will balance each other. No, it doesn't, because Parashara has already said that whenever you are doing prediction, do as per the time and place, which yuga, which place, which timing you are doing, you should consider this. So you can't match Mars Mangal Dosha with Saturn. Now previously what happened, either partner will be active. If Mangal Dosha is there, he will be active, and who has a Saturn Dosha will be passive. So opposite attracts. See, it doesn't attract in the, it's not a science, it's a one's life. So one partner will always suffer and another partner will always dominate. It might be either a male or female. So you cannot match Mars with the Saturn. I highly oppose this, even though if somebody will oppose me, but I will not change my view, because Saturn have this own. Once people will read that Naveen Bhai Javeri book, Shani Mangal Yuti Pratyuti, then they will come to know Shani, that Saturn and Mars, no way they can join together. Okay, so it's not a shield, One should not use a shield. Why one partner will always suffer? Why? Are I have seen nowadays that your ready-made software says that if one has a Mars and another has Sun, match him. One has a Mars and one has a Rahu, match him. How? Mars can only give effect and oppose against Mars only. How the another planet can take over the result of a Mars? No, it can't possible. So Mars can be only been adjusted against Mars only. So my dear friends, there are so much exception. Why you are matching with the Saturn, Rahu and Sun? No, it can't be. Mars will be Mars. Mars is desire. Saturn is surety. How so desire and surety will match? Never. Desire means I want now, now. And Saturn say no. I will give you sometime when my time will come. That can't match. Rahu, that's too strange that people match a Mangal Dosha with the Rahu. Oof. And they can sometime match with the Sun. No, I don't advise. If you getting late marriage is okay. But why you are creating some accidents? It's nothing but the accident. So Mangal has to be matched with the Mangal only. And that also there are so much exception I have given. So by using such an exception, one has to find that there is no Mangal Dosha. Even there is a placement of Mangal, you don't have a Mangal. No Mars Dosha, no Kuja Dosha. So you don't have to worry about it. So first of all, you see, you learn what is Mars, what is Mangal Dosha. Then only compare Mars with the another planet. So that's about the Mars. Those who having a Mangal Dosha or Mars, after seeing all this exception, after applying a play exception, if that's left out, then that means you have some separate and special energy. Don't treat yourself a hint. See, you will find always those who have a Mangal Dosha, they will always incline towards science line, medical line, engineering, technical line, whereby they will only settle after the age of 26, 28, 30. See, doctor, MBBS, MD, double MD, DM, super speciality, by doing this, they will reach the age of 28, 30. See, those who having a pimple, see, many times you will feel a face that there is a heat near the face somewhere. That's the first indication of Mars. Those who having a Mangal Dosha, they will come. See, this is also my observation. Don't take it as golden words. I have seen that if there is a Mangal Dosha or the Mangal is Mars is highly affected, then there will be a heat. Either they have on the face, or either they have a burning sensation, or either the stomach is always upset due to the heat. So this is all indication you have a Mangal Dosha, and you should accept, yes, I am different. I am different from others. I have Mangal Dosha. You should admit. And that means you have something extra energy than others. See, Mars never been destructive. You have to use the energy in the correct sense. As I already says, Mars is nothing but the strength, energy and enthusiasm. How this will be bad? If it is positively seated, then you have a very positive attitude towards the life. See, as I also have a Mangal Dosha, so many, that's a great thing that I know and I aware about the Mangal Dosha and my gurus. I can not forget my gurus, my C.S. Patel sir, master in Navans. Lemon Tucker, I have spoke that name also previously, and in my guru video also I have given the photo of my guru. You can see my guru's photo and you will also get blessed. He was also very famous and he wrote so many books and he was expert in medical astrology. I am going to start a medical astrology very soon by bless of my guru. And my best guru is Dr. M.V. Mehta. You will find so many, the predictive technique book is written by him and he is now no more. But guru is always remain in our heart. So he has given me so much. See, C.S. Patel sir, I always go to him. C.S. Patel sir also I met due to my guru, Dr. M.V. Mehta. Due to him, because he always interact each other. So I met him. So my guru, that Mahasubhai Mehta, has wrote one book that's predictive techniques, and so many ascendant he has written in the marriage astrology he has written. In there he has also mentioned all this Mangal Dosha. and I have learned from him only. I am not shying and that saying that this all are my own knowledge and my own creation. No, everything is given by him. And after applying 27 years, now I am very firm that these rules work. So my dear friends, just apply Mars and don't hesitate saying that yes, I have Mangal Dosha. That courage should be there. See, Mangal is not only a fighting. Mangal is nothing but strength, courage and enthusiasm. They have something different approach than others. So that's all about the Mangal Dosha. We can come, the viewers can come out with the many new things. See, I have what I have covered, I have to give that's a very good suggestion by one of my viewers in Bangalore. No, she is from Chennai. So she has given this, sir, after the video, just give a summary so that people will recall everything. So in summary, we'll see what is a Mangal Dosha I have seen, in which house it affects, what is a Mangal, how physically it affects, why it has to be seen during the marriage only, not for the other purpose, being its consummation is going to happen. So that is a Mangal Dosha. Then, see, for loyalty, one point I have left is that's a loyalty I have just spoken and I left. For loyalty of each and other, you will find that things in my marriage video, that distance between your Mars to another partner Venus and another partner Mars to your Venus. If you learn how to see this, amazing, because Mars is a desire and Venus is a pleasure. When you desire, whether your partner give you pleasure or not, and where your partner desire about something, whether you give her pleasure or not, her or him. So that also can be seen. And the loyalty, whether your partner will be only for you or he might be turned to another, that all can be seen also from the Mars and Venus. I have researched so many and for Mars and Venus, I have to confess what I have not researched. So okay, so that also I will share sometime. And whatever I promise, I give. So viewers, we have seen the Mars dosha. We have seen why it has to be considered, which house it should be there, how physically it affects, what are the exception of a Mangal dosha. That's very important. We have also seen all 12 Lagnas, where Mars is a doshkarak or not doshkarak, and what are the remedies. People always ask about what are the remedies. See, for remedies, if somebody have a Mangal dosha, by fasting you can reduce, because fasting, see, not on the Tuesday only, you can fast any days, by which your acid level will decrease, because that day, the day when you don't eat, you use less amount of acid and that acid will be diluted immediately. So by fasting, see, if during fasting, take care that you should not consume any salty item. That's only a restriction, because when you don't consume the salt, then your chakras get clean, and that is the best time where you get a fasting. Eat anything, better is a fruit and milk, but if you do fasting, do eat anything. And for Mangal Mars, Ganeshji, a best thing, because a Mangal Bhavan, a Mangal Hari, that is a Mangal, right? So one can pray Lord Ganesha for Mangal. Om Gam Ganpati Nama, Om Am Angarakai Nama, that is all a Bija Mantra for Mangal and Ganeshji. That also relief. You don't have to sit one place and do, continuously mentally you chant and your Mars will activate it. I have activated every planet. That is why I know what the things are working or whether the things are not working. Okay. So now that's a remedy. One can also give a red dal, you know, masoor, that red dal without chilka, without the cover, that you make wet in the Monday night, you put in the water, somewhat water you put, and so that becomes a soft. And next day you can feed it to the cow. Because cow is sun, it will all absorb the energy of a Mars. So that is also a best energy. There is a Parvala also, that is a coral. There is a coral Ganesh also available. Coral Ganesh, again that is a Mangal only. That you can pray, you can keep in the earth. But I don't advise to wear a coral. See, that means you already have energy and you are enhancing that energy. How it can be possible? Once somebody is distracting you and you are giving power to him, it will distract in the more sense. So don't wear this pearl, always pray. By praying you can reduce the effect of this Mars. So I believe I have covered everything about the Mangal Dosha and Mangal. So now viewers doesn't have any balanced things, and now people can enjoy with having a Mangal Dosha. Okay, so not to worry about the Mangal and take rest and put good views in my channel DM Astrology if you like. Please do share it, because by sharing only this right knowledge will spread to the world. I am doing not only for the Indians, I am not doing for any particular thing, I am doing for the world to know what are the Vedic and the secrets lies in our Vedic astrology. Okay, so do share it with all your circle or your viewers, and give a good feedbacks, like my videos by pressing the like button, and do subscribe and encourage others to subscribe to my channel DM Astrology. Hope you like this video very much, very informative, and give me feedback. Thank you. Thank you very much.